Hello everybody, hope you all are doing well and hope you all are staying safe. In my previous session, we had seen the intent which is used to capture the video so that we can develop our own applications using just one line of intent, okay? So in today's session, we will see what is the call sequence which has to be followed in the correct order in order to capture a video. So if we decide not to use intent, if we try to follow the entire call sequence, then this video will be very helpful. A call sequence to capture video is not that simple as the one which I had already shown, the call sequence to capture an image, okay? So image, we just check if the device have access to camera, and we will get the camera resource, open the camera, we'll set the preview, and we'll click an image. Once an image is captured, we will release the camera resource. But in the case of video, there are many additional parameters and other features which will come into picture. So without any delay, let's get started. And by the way, this is Dimple here. So video capture using Android framework requires careful management of the camera object and coordination with the media recorder class. So here, mainly we will be using a media recorder class. Unlike taking pictures with a device camera, capturing video requires very particular call order. So we have to follow the exact order. If we miss any step in between, then our video application will not be working. So there are series of steps which I'll be telling one by one. Okay. First few steps are very similar to whatever I had shown in my previous video related to capturing an image. So step one is open camera. That's obvious, right? Use the camera.open function to get an instance of the camera object. So this is the main function. We have to open the camera. Step two is we have to connect the preview. So connect the preview. Preview means what? We have to create a live camera image. Okay. And we have to prepare all the surface view using camera.setPrevewDisplay function. So setPrevewDisplay function will make the UI to be ready. So that UI will give us a live experience to capture a video. That was step two. So in step one, we are opening the camera using camera.open function. In step two, we are setting the preview. In step three, we will start the preview. Okay, this is the time where we see the video icon at the bottom of our application, so that when we click on that video icon, video will start getting recorded. So for that, we have to use start preview function to begin displaying the live camera image. So first three steps are almost similar to whatever we had seen in the case of capturing an image. Okay, so the actual role of capturing the video starts from step four. So we have to start the video recording, and the following steps has to be completed in correct order, okay, for successful video record session. So first, what we have to do under step four, there are few sub steps. Okay. First we have to unlock the camera using camera unlock function. So this camera unlock function is not required in case when we are capturing an image. This is an additional step which comes when we are capturing a video. Then we have to use media recorder here. We have to use an instance of media recorder. So whenever we are capturing an image, we never used media recorder instance. Okay, we just used few APIs which will open the camera, which will set the preview, start the preview, and we captured dot capture function we used. That's all. We never used media recorder. So here we have to make use of media recorder instance. Okay. So media recorder, in that we have to use set camera function, which will basically set the camera to be used for video capture. Use your application's current instance of camera. So you can choose here if you want front camera or back camera. So we have to set the camera, and we have to set the audio source. Okay. When we are capturing video, we know, right, audio comes into picture, all these things comes into picture. So we have to set the audio source. So we have to use media recorder dot audio source, and audio source camcorder profile will be used. Then we have to set the video source as well. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to first create an instance of media recorder, we have to set the camera, we have to make sure audio source is set. So there is camcorder profiles. Okay, this profile will have different values in. Okay, if we want high definition video or low quality video, all that we can define in this profile. So each profile will have a particular value in it. Then we have to set the video source. Once this is done, continuation of step 4, set the video output format. So now input we set camera, we set audio source, we set video source. Now output also we have to design, right? So we have to get the profile instance using camcorder profile dot get. As I already told, camcorder profile is used for audio purpose, and each profile will have different values. Okay. So we have to set output format, set the output format, for example, MPEG-4, like that output format, set audio encoder. Different types of audio encoders are present. So whichever audio encoder you are interested in, you have to set that particular audio encoder and video encoder as well. So we have to set the output format, audio encoder, video encoder. This much we are doing in step 4. And still, yes, we have continuation of step 4. Set the output file. Okay, one thing you have to notice is whenever we capture an image using a camera, what will happen, that image will not be stored. Okay, we have to externally write the code in order to store that image. We can use file URI or content URI. But what we can observe is whenever we capture any video, we have to make sure we are setting the output file. The video will be saved, whatever we capture will be saved. So that output media file we have to use, and set preview display, which will specify the surface view preview layout element for your application. So what are we doing in step 4? Once again, I'll tell. Step 4 basically will make use of media recorder instance. Okay, so media recorder instance will make use, will prepare the input. Input is set audio source, set video source and camera, all that will make sure it's working. Then we'll set the output format, audio encoder, video encoder, how our output should be saved, that we will decide here. And the path where it has to be saved, all that things we will decide. And then after after preparing the input format, output format, the path where the video should be saved, we will prepare the media recorder using media recorder dot prepare function. Okay, so this prepare function will basically initialize all the resources which are required in order to capture your video. So once everything is ready, now our input format we have decided, output how our video should be saved we have decided, where it should be saved also we have decided, and we have prepared, that means we have initialized all the resources. Now what's remaining? Yes, we have to just start the media recorder. So media recorder dot start function we have to use, so that our video capturing process will begin. So that was step 4. Okay, step 4 basically think about input output, start the media recorder. Media recorder will come into picture. Next, step 5. Now once we have started our video recording, we have to stop it, right? Obviously. So we will call stop media recorder function, media recorder dot stop to stop. If we want to reset it, then we will call media recorder dot reset. If we want to release it, we will use media recorder dot release. Then lock the camera. So basically, first step we had seen, we will unlock the camera. Okay, so now here we have to lock the camera. Lock the camera so that future media recorder sessions use it by calling camera lock. This we have to use it. Okay. So main important point is, do not forget to use this function media recorder.release. So once you have used the camera resource for capturing video, make sure you release it in your on pause calls, on stop calls of your application, because if you fail to release these resources, no one else can use the camera resources. Stop the preview. When your activity has finished, call stop preview function and release. So releasing the camera is very, very important and crucial part. So release your media recorder instance also and release the camera instance also. That was all about I had for today. I hope this was informative and helpful. Please stay tuned with my upcoming videos to get more information on multimedia framework in Android. So everyone, stay home, stay safe. I'll meet y'all in my next session. Take care. Bye.